Your work always tells a story. Let's have a close look.
Hello, welcome back. I'm here with Leonardo. So, you're a man of busy, multiple things happening at once. How is it that you managed to look this good and keep finding time to do other activities? So how do you manage your time?
It's good. A while ago, I used to like to say, oh, I'm busy, I'm super busy, to people see that I was doing things. And until I listened to a video of Jim Rohn, right? He said, don't fake out being busy. You have to be productive. So productivity is the key. It's not like busy. If you are busy doing like things that it's not worthy, you are wasting your time. You have to be productive. And time cannot be managed. Earl Nightingale said once that time cannot be managed. You only can manage activities. So we have 24 hours in a day. I have 24 hours, you have 24 hours, Jeff Bezos has 24 hours, Bill Gates has 24 hours. But it's not the hours that count, it's the quality you put in hours. So that's why being busy doesn't mean you are putting money in your pocket. It means that you have to put money in your pocket if you are productive. So the key to find the balance of business, relationships, healthy, it's in the beginning, it's not complicated at all, but you need the discipline, right? You have to find a balance, because in the beginning, I used to read a lot, but I stopped to go to the gym, and this was bad. I was reading a lot, going to the gym, but I wasn't paying attention to my wife. So you have to find the balance. I believe if you have a good schedule with good activities, you have to find. And the key things to everything in life is the desire. If you don't have the desire, you're not gonna have the willing to pay the price and change. You have to have that burning desire inside you that says, I will make it or I will die. There is no plan B. I will do it or you're gonna find me on the sidewalk dead. Like, there is no plan B. I will do or I die. So when you have the decision, oh God, you have everything. The universe, God, whatever you wanna call, will help you because you got the decision. So with the feet, it's exactly the same way. If you are getting the feet to say, oh, look at me, poor me, oh, nobody like me. However, if you try to see a good thing in every defeat, Napoleon Hill says that. If you're trying to find a good benefits from each defeat, the feet stop coming. Because the feet, it will say, why am I bothering to come to this person if he doesn't mind, right? So you have to find a very good side of the thing of every bad situation.
It's that work-life balance that you're talking about there. That's very important, right? I'm just trying to understand.
Yeah, okay. Because the topic, it's like the rainbows. They are so close, they are so connected that you cannot see the limitation, the start of one and the end of water. That's why you ask sometimes one question, I just go to the next question, because they are so connected. Yeah. So, but you must find the balance. You cannot focus only in your intelligence, in your mind, and forget your body to eat health. So I know that's not a Jim Rohn's quote, but I learned from Jim Rohn's.
You're allowed to make your own quotes. Yeah. You know that.
But Jim Rohn used to say, one apple a day keeps the doctor away. It's not his quote, but he says in every single seminar, one apple a day keeps the doctor away. And guess what? I start eating one apple a day. And something, this is very crucial, and it's a very good that I'm talking about, because don't think, not even for a second, that if you neglect an apple a day, it's not going to interfere in your health in the future. Jim Rohn said that one act leads to another act. If you don't eat an apple a day, you're not going to go around the block. You're not going to jog. You're not going to go to the gym. You're not going to go do this. So he said, if you remove one, you start the catastrophe, the life catastrophe. Everything affects everything.
Chain of consequences.
Exactly, it's like domino effect. So he said, don't be naive enough to tell yourself, oh no, one apple a day, no. One Hershey bar a day, no. He said, no, you are being naive. You are being like silly, Don't fake out. Just because catastrophe doesn't come at the end of the day doesn't mean catastrophe is not coming. It's coming.
Yeah.
You have to see that. You have to see, you have to have the responsibility to see what my present acts and attitudes is bringing me in the next 5 years. If you are eating junk foods every day, if you're not going to the gym, if you don't treat your father, your mother, your sister, your wife good, it's not mean because they are with you, they will keep staying with you in the 5 years. You have to see that coming. So I believe the key is to project yourself in the next 5 years and see what my attitudes today are bringing me. If you don't like the result you are seeing today, means that you have to change what you are doing.
Okay, so you touched on this a little bit, and I don't know if it's a touchy subject, but faith, belief. You talked about whether it be God, whether it be universe. I'm curious as to if you have a belief system. Like, what is it that keeps you going aside from your wife? You have already given her enough praise. Let's talk about you a little bit. What is it that you, do you believe in something or universe?
Yes, I believe in God. And I watched recently, like 2 years ago, a video of Bob Proctor. He said that faith and fear is two things that you cannot see, but you believe. So, if you have faith, you can achieve anything you want in your life. If you have fear, you cannot achieve. But it's the same coin of different faces. Both demand you to believe in something you can't see it. But most of the people, because of their paradigm, believe in fear. If you believe in fear, you are not going with the universal laws, with God. So regarding what I believe in God, I believe in a higher force, in a higher universe, right? I believe nothing like as this perfection is by coincidence. I believe something designed it, right? So, but what I believe as well, that we are that something as well. We are a part of that something. I believe that is a biblical, I'm not super religious, right? But there is a biblical said that we are the God's image. But the mistake is thinking that God has our image. No, we have God's image, our essence, everything, it's energy, right? And there is another quote that says, not even one leaf will fall if God doesn't know. God knows everything because God is in everywhere. God, it's in me, it's in you, it's in every single one, the good, the bad person, because we are the essence of that intelligence, of that they call like the higher force, I call God, but it's everywhere.
Damn, that's deep. That's super deep. I don't even know how to segue into the next area, so I'm just gonna go right into it. So you talked about belief, you talked about how to make yourself better, you talked about how to inspire others to a better form of thinking for not only themselves, but the people around them, and how to attract the positivity. You read a lot. So I actually want you to say there is a kid or a person out there that's like, you know what? I do jive with what he's saying. What is it that he's reading exactly? I mean, it could be something that's influencing you now, or something that you read when you just started this whole journey. What would you suggest? I'm going to give you top five because I don't want you to, we don't need 100 books.
Okay.
So five.
That's a good thing. So top five books. My first book that I started to read and was the first book ever is, and in English, was The Power of Awareness by Neville Goddard. The first chapter he tells about I am. Like you are. Before you be a success, before you be anything, you have to realize, you have to have the awareness that you are something. Like I am wealth, I am abundant. Before the second word, the third word, you have to realize that you are something. So the first chapter, it's little complicated, but if you go through, all works miracle in your life. That is a book. So The Power of Awareness. Working with the Law by Raymond Holyoad. Working with the Law that talks about the universal laws. It's fantastic. It's fantastic.
Sorry, I don't mean to interrupt. We'll get into the third book here. But now, I don't read a lot, as much as you. However, we seem to share a lot of like opinions that are the same. I just want to make it clear to everybody that you don't like, and it's okay to read if you read a lot, that's fine. But all these things you could search through any podcast, like Audible, audio books and stuff like that. I just want to make that clear. Just
it's a very good point, because some people, they start to get discouraged of that. So in life, you can learn from two experiences, your own mistake or someone else's mistake, right? So it doesn't mean because I read those books, in order you to get the same knowledge, you have to read the book. You can have the same knowledge without reading, because it's already inside you, right? So for me, it was a little complicated for me, because I didn't have the knowledge, right? So for me, I had to pay more price than probably you have to pay. For me, it was a little difficult. Sometimes one of you already have the knowledge deep inside you that you don't have to go through the same thing I went through.
Different journeys for everybody.
Exactly. Like for me, the way that I found myself to learn is through books, because you have to have a mentor. If you want to be above the average, right? If you want to be above the average, you have to have a mentor. There is nothing wrong to be the average. But if you don't want to be above the average and you are the average, that is something wrong, right? You have to push yourself. You have to pay the price. You have to pay the price. People are expecting a little red button. They press, boom, the genius, the lamp genius. Hey, I wanted this. That's a good question. What is the lamp genius of the Aladdin? It's the universe. Ask, what do you want? Tell me, what do you want? You have to know what you want.
I haven't thought of that.
You have to know what you want. The genius is just a representation of the God of the universe. First, you have to know what you want, and then he's gonna give you. The problem of our society, we don't know what we want, and we are getting trash, and we are blaming. But it's not God's fault, it's our fault, because we are not clear what we want. God, I want this, this, and that. And this, it's a link with my third recommendation. Feeling is the Secret by Neville Goddard. You have to feel your wish already, fulfill it. What do you mean, Leo?
What do you mean?
This took me a while to understand, but probably we're not gonna take you a while to understand. I can't teach English if I don't know English. I can't teach Japanese if I don't know Japanese. In order to teach, I have to know. Yep. How come I'm expecting to be wealthy if I am not already wealthy? I don't mean in the possession physically, I mean in the mental world. You have to feel that you are already the person you want to be before you manifest in an outer world. That's the thing. And it's a book of 43, 44 pages. Feeling is the secret. Because if you feel, it's gonna happen. And the second book that I said, Working with the Law, that is page 61, at least in my book, talks about the law of attraction. He says, never expect something you don't desire. And never desire something you don't expect. Desire will elevate your vibration to a frequency of what you want. Expectation will maintain your vibration in that frequency, which will bring the thing you want in your life. I will give you a perfect example. You know, a lot of people on YouTube, they want to break a glass. They start and they can break the glass. Remember, like the wine glass. The thing is, once the person starts doing, they are getting in the same frequency of the glass. That's why it breaks. So once they start, they already are in the same frequency. However, they have to maintain with this to break the glass. So the desire, it's the first part. The expectancy is the second, which you maintain in that, and then you're going to break the glass. So the desire puts you in frequency, in the same level, and expectations will bring into your life. So never desire something you don't expect, and never expect something you don't desire. I am sorry if I am overload, you know, it's fantastic. So that's the third book.
Sometimes it's nice to have a little overload because then you could go to bed, you could watch this video later, and then really, soak it up. Like you said, reading books, it's like that. If you want to learn something, YouTube has a lot of tutorials. If you watch the video over and over and over and over and over again, then you're going to know what's up, right?
Yeah.
So anyways, yes, fourth book.
Fourth book, I would say that it's by Greg Braden. The Divine Matrix explains about what you can call God, because there is a field. Albert Einstein says that we are submerged in a field. So think this field as the water of a tank. So we have the fish and you have the water. So the water, it's what connects every single fish, because we are all connected. Even though we can't see it, this, we are connected. There is no such thing as empty space, right? So the Divine Matrix tells about this field and talks about how you interact, how you can manifest anything you want in your life. But you have to follow, you have to speak exactly the language which the universe understand. And the language universe understand, it's not word. It's not word. How come we, like the person that can talk? So they're not talking with the God? It's by feeling.
Yeah, action and feeling.
It's by feeling. Of course, you have to act. You have to put it straight three things. Your thinking, okay, your feelings, and your action. If you think that you're gonna get your business, perfect. But if you don't feel like, ah, bullshit, nah, I don't have capacity, but you work every day, nothing's gonna happen. You have to put it straight, the three. Feelings, thinking, feelings, and action. You have to act, you have to pay the price. And the fourth book, it's Greg Braden as well. It's The Secret of Lost Mode of Prayer. I believe it's in this order, The Secret of Lost Mode of Prayer. He teaches you how to speak with the universe, with the Divine Matrix, how to get what you want. And of course, please read Jim Rohn's book as well. Jim Rohn's. I'm a big fan. I start completely changing my life once I start reading Jim Rohn.
You can't see it on camera, but his eyes literally just lit up when he said that name. Look at he's it's not just because it's cold out here.
It's not cold. It's excitement. I just feel bad for Simi because she's
sitting on the side. The producer Simi's off camera over there. She's just sitting
and
on the couch.
My wife as well.
They're cold, so we're gonna we'll close this out. So if anybody wants to get, is there a way to contact you if they want to talk to you about anything on their mind? Is there a way to contact you?
Absolutely, please. I can give you my personal phone number to them. They can call me, or I have WeChat and I have WhatsApp. I believe WhatsApp is much better.
Whoa, hang on. You don't have a Facebook? I'm just kidding. There's no Twitters. There's no Instagram. He didn't start off with any of those. He gave a WhatsApp.
I'm old. Like, I have a very old soul. Like, I don't even watch TV. Because, you know, as I said earlier, TV are dumping things.
Oh, I'm out of here. I'm
so, no. Some TVs dump you in your mind. Trash. Right?
We're on TV. No.
Some TVs. Not this one. This one are given the opportunity to tell that to you.
So, if people want to get a hold of you, is there a place that they could go do that?
Of course. So, please feel free to reach me on my Instagram account. You just put a Leo Onyx. So, the link probably it's underneath, up, somewhere here. Yeah. Please feel free. You can reach me anytime you want. I really want to help you. I really want to understand how am I able to help, you know? I believe we have to be the change we want to see in the world. I believe Madre Teresa said that. You have to be the change you want to be in the world. You want to see in the world. Yeah. So I want to help.
There you go. Leonardo.
Thank you so much for the opportunity. Thank you so much, Simi, for this amazing opportunity that I could share with you guys. I know probably it was a long video, but the key is to watch over and over and over and over. Repetition, it's the way we learn things. It's through repetition. That's why you speak the language you speak, through repetition. Not by coincidence, through repetition. Success leaves clues.
We could go all day with inspirational quotes and whatnot. However, if you have someone that is as inspirational as Leonardo here, I just love that name, Leonardo. Just going to say it over and over again. If you want to find us, you can find us on CloseLook.ca. You can go to the Facebook, CloseLook Productions, or you can find me on my Facebook, Daniel Westbay. Everything I put will be somewhere on the screen. It might be covering up his face because the camera loves it way too much. I'm going to be honest here. He's just that hair. It's just, anyways.
Thank you so much for the opportunity to
thank
be
you.
In the cold weather.
Oh
here.
My God, it's you just see it? My hand's frozen. Anyways, thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm Daniel Westbay for Close Look, and we are here at a huge, huge event. Close Look Got Talent, where all walks of life, all generations, kids, adults, teenagers, they got a talent. This is where they are. So let's head on inside and check out all the greatness.
Good afternoon, everybody. It feels like more like night because we are in a theater, and I think my heel nearly went through the hole that the wires come out of, right? So I've survived that one on the go, and it's really nice to be here. I want to congratulate all of the organizers for putting this event on and for engaging so many of the youth and the community in doing something positive. We always hear about kids and youth and always about the negative things in the media. But I can say that my personal experience has been 99% of our youth are engaged in really positive things. And here is another example where they are engaged and you as community members are involved as well.
It's available on Amazon. So I'll just read out some pieces out for you guys. Reflection. That day forever in remembrance. That day was so pure, so magical. Who knew that I could live so much while being dead? Laying in my bed, palms pressed together, and off I went. To the place of no destination, covered in white from head to toe, I walked. Heaven and hell are temporary, and this place was permanent. The day I closed off one gate and entered another. Not by choice, not by force, but by the way my destiny was written. I left the world and I didn't miss it. It is selfish to say that I did not miss anyone, but it's true, I didn't. The list of worldly pleasures are infinite. In remembrance, I turned my back away from it all. It is then when I gained the universe by my hand in total humility that death itself was at my feet, serving me. Guruji gave me the sword that day, and I cut off the nose of all illusions. That pleasure that surrounds the entire world, gone. And I was in total serenity. Oh, formless and eternal one, I will forever fall at your feet. I am so blessed to have met you, and I can't wait to come back. You were the sun, and I was a water beneath this land. Mixed with the dirt of my own identity, with the warmth of your love, I evaporated. The heat of your love came with unforeseeable problems that started to take over. I grew large to withstand the demands of your nature. I turned big and black, condensed under the pressure of my own head. I let myself go, droplet by droplet, from our conjunction.
Thank you so much. Thank you, parents, for encouraging your children, for taking time out for them from your busy schedules, and taking them to practices, buying them instruments, getting them join the classes, and we are there. If you need us to showcase their talent, CloseLook is there.